All right, there's me. I can hear me. Can I hear you?
Hello.
I can hear you. And then we cut over to the stream. There we go. It's starting time, everyone. Welcome to the stream, the Elden Ring Challenge stream. This one in particular. Oh, wait. Get back over here. This one in particular, I am playing as a warrior Jar, a.k.a. Jarls Barkley. And yes. I'm joined by the wonderful, talented, and dare I say handsome, Marty Sliva.
Oh my gosh, Jack, thank you so much for having me. And this stream is sponsored by good folks at Jolly Good Soda Pop. Nope, made that up. I'd like to get a sponsorship by the good folks at Jolly Good Soda Pop.
Do you think if we just say that often enough, like good Jolly Good will send us some soda?
Yeah, or like we should invoice them. Be like, oh, you guys didn't realize you sponsored our stream?
Yeah.
And Jolly Good has so much money that they won't even know what's going on. Is Jolly Good, is that just a Wisconsin thing? Is that even national?
Like, you're talking about like the fruit-flavored soda, Jolly Good.
Yeah, yeah. And I used to have it a lot when I was a kid. Mm-hmm. Jolly Good.
Jolly
yeah.
Good,
yeah. Hipperk. Says Jack is real quiet.
Jack is real. I am not. I am maybe slightly quieter. Hold on. Here we go.
Oh, no, you were. I just listened to it and you sounded fine.
No, I'm fine.
You sounded fine. That's a classic Hipper goof.
That's a like if I talk like this and if I talk away from my microphone, which might have happened, I've turned myself up slightly so everyone can hear
okay.
me.
Okay. Nick said the audio was fine.
Thank
and
you,
Nick.
Nick
is a homeowner.
Thank
so
you.
He would know.
So he wait a minute. I don't think those two things
homeowners have very good ears for audio.
Correlated. Okay, no. So to catch everyone up on the stream, here's what happened. We are playing as a warrior Jar. The rules for this challenge run is I may only hit people. Hold on, here we go. Ugh! When I have my crag blade fists on, then I am a warrior Jar. Mm-hmm. Oh, that's a sick ass move.
It's so cool looking.
The only armor I am allowed to wear has to be jar shaped. So literally there is only one piece of armor I can wear.
Yeah.
And that's the challenge. Last time we just raised up our spiked cestuses a little bit and absolutely melted Margit and Godfrey.
Yeah, it was wild. How quickly we beat Godfrey.
Yeah.
Like, I think we were telling a goof story, and then we looked up, and it was done.
It was done. No summons, no whatever. Yeah. This time, hold on. We can add a charge to our flask, so we're going to definitely do that. And can I level up? Ooh, and I can even level up.
Ooh.
So our cestuses are scaling with strength, and so basically every level we get is either vigor, strength, or endurance, because eventually we will need to... be able to carry our giant piece of jar armor.
Mm-hmm.
For the time being, let's go vigor just to make sure we can take some more hits.
Heck yeah.
For this episode, for this live stream, our priority is thus. We're going to get some more smithing stones. We are going to get the soul jars of fortune. I don't need you. Which is the only spirit summons that we can utilize, as those are the only jar spirit summons.
Yeah, but they're nice. They're nice little guys. And then we can also, in terms of character summon Alexander into someone in chat. Who was it that mentioned? Are we fighting Radahn tonight? Pure Pyro said Radahn fight tonight. Are we going to be doing some Radahn fighting?
I think once we get stones, once we get the soul jars, I think we go Radahn, and if we have time, Renala. I think we can do Radahn, Red Wolf, Renala all in one go.
That'd be redonkulous.
Wouldn't it
that
be?
That was a Radahn joke.
Redonkulous.
Yeah.
But we need some threes and fours is what we need. We need smithing stone threes, smithing stones four. Especially for the Radahn fight, the only person I can summon for the Radahn fight is Alexander.
Mm-hmm.
Patches,
because Patches just turns around and runs away, which I think is great. Patches, you summon him, and he's just like, I don't want to be here. I'm not interested in this fight.
Yeah, he nopes right on out.
Yeah.
Which is great. Oh, fuck. Crab.
And welcome to everyone in chats. Everyone in YouTube. We got Beastmarsh, Eve, Fate, Pacific Blue, Daniel, Noversia. Welcome everyone in Twitch.
Yeah.
Rich Lucas, Pride and Balls, Pure Pyro, Speakeasy,
yes.
Lampy. Just resubscribed at tier 3. Been a member for 40 months.
Holy
40.
Lampy.
Lampy, you are a ground floorsman. Says, nice to see Jack, the Soul Master, and Marty, the number one Sonic fan, streaming again. It's true, I am the number one Sonic fan.
Is that
as
true?
Someone who's completed Sonic Adventure 1 and none of the other games yet, I think I'm number one.
Yeah, that's really all you need.
Yeah.
Right. Okay, we need some Smythe and Stones.
Do you know where they are? Do you need me to look them up?
I have the Fextra Life open, and
okay.
I was hoping. Oh wait, we need to go to the Crystal Tunnel. I guess I can go over here. I was hoping to just pick them up in the world. So we are going to head into the Raya Lucaria Crystal Tunnel to go get all. We need 9 threes and 12 fours because you need. Because when you are scaling your regular weapons, when you're upgrading your regular weapons, the first step is you need 2 of the stones, then you need 4 of the stones, then you need 6 of the stones.
Heck yeah.
Whew. And so I need... Oh, wait, maybe there's some in here. That's a teleporter. So, yeah, we need some stones, y'all. So we are going to head over to the Raya Lucaria Crystal Tunnel, which apparently has 8 total threes. And then we just need one more and we'll be good to go.
That's a 24.
And
8 threes is a 24.
8 threes is a 24. And then we need one more, so that makes 25. And 25, you're doing alive.
Do you like needing specific numbers of stones, or do you think it should have been like you need a total of 50 stone points to upgrade this, and you can give me 50 stone ones or you know, 10 stone fives, that kind of thing.
I see what you're saying. Where it's like, you could have, I think that would encourage grinding.
That would encourage grinding, whereas this encourages exploration and trying to figure out, oh, this is where stone fours are.
Yes.
Kind of thing.
Theoretically, you need to move forward with this system in order to get the hardier stones. And so, yeah, they want to encourage the player to move forward. Wait, where's the... God damn it, where's the thing? Where's the goddamn tunnel?
You know who I like? I like the jellyfish. Because they just kind of hang out.
I also like the jellyfish.
In a world where everything is so angry, they're just kind of hanging out.
They're just there. They're just there. And I also think, like, they are put there on purpose to be, like, a big glowing beacon. To say, hey, there's something
over
here.
Catch your eye. Yeah.
Which I love. I love the little jellyfish story from the precious little jellyfish that we get from Rotorica.
Oh, so good.
Later on when you're like, wait a minute. It has a home? It had a family? Wait a minute. Spirits, like, because we know, like,
yeah.
if you read the there it is. If you read the descriptions, you know that spirit summons are like, you know, the souls of warriors forever caught in battle.
Mm-hmm.
And you know that to be true, except for when your jellyfish turns out to be just an adorable little girl,
yeah,
who's like wanted to visit the stars but died. Spoiler alert.
Yeah, that's really sad.
Probably should have said that before.
Michael Zaki, why are you doing this? Eve Daly, thank you so much. Eve with a €2 donation said,
Eve.
Would you ever challenge run another FromSoft game? I guess if you were to challenge run another FromSoft game, which one do you think you'd choose?
Ooh. You know, possibly. This has been a lot of fun. I think this, for me, Elden Ring is the most flexible.
Agreed. Absolutely agreed.
Of the FromSoft. And so, here we are. So what I would worry about is, I do not think I'm a great player. I am not, like, the best player in the world. What I am... good at. Oh, I don't need a smithing stone to get out of town. What I am good at is just kind of knowing where the cheese is at, you know.
Mm.
Knowing enough to get by. And so what I worry about for other FromSoft games is me just not being good enough to complete the challenge.
Yeah. And like you said, there's like a rigidity to some of the FromSoft games that, like, well, you could like choose to play the original Dark Souls as a sorcerer, or you can choose to play it as sort of like your own barbarian. But I feel like it has less options that this has to really get into the nitty gritty and be like, I want to role play as blank.
Yes. Precisely. Somber 3. Great. Precisely. Whereas this one, it's like, yeah, if you just want to do everything poison all the time, all of that's available to you right from the get-go, and you can really have fun with that. Whereas I'm trying to remember even how, like, poisoning people in Dark Souls 1, you needed dung piles, and then it also poisoned you, if I'm remembering correctly. Actually, well, someone did that. Someone did a dung pie only run in Dark Souls.
A dung? Jeez.
Yeah.
I think all games should have a dung pie only run, for being honest. Right. Lampy with a 200 little bitty donation over on Twitch. Thank you so much, Lampy. Says, I meant to ask this ages ago, but kept forgetting. Jack, how did you get on with your bone headphones? Your bone phones? And was the audio quality any good?
My bone?
What are your bone? Bone phone is ready.
First of all, fuck yeah.
Bone size ready.
Oh man,
what's going on with your bone phones?
R.I.P.
What's your bone phone?
Macho Man Randy Savage. Let me get out of danger here, and I will show you what's going on with my bone phones.
Wow, you guys didn't think this would be a little show and tell, did you?
Yeah, bone
show. Story with your eyes.
There we go. So these guys right here, these are, what are these? Aftershocks. These are Aftershocks, which are bone conducting wireless headphones. Can you guys see these?
Oh my God. So they sort of just like
they don't go in your ear. They don't go in your ear. They sit like in front of your ear, basically, right?
That's crazy.
And so I was having a problem in which I'm a bit of an Apple fanboy, and I genuinely love AirPods. I think AirPods are some of the greatest headphones ever to be invented. The problem with AirPods is they're very small, and I leave them in my pockets and then wash my pants.
That's not good. At least you're washing your pants, though. That's
yes,
good.
I'm happy to be washing my pants, but what I found was I've ruined. So after my second pair of AirPods got ruined after sending them through both the washer and the dryer, I scolded myself and I said, "You are not responsible enough for AirPods, sir."
Mm-hmm.
So I
you're not doing your duty as like an AirPod father.
As the AirPod father, I love
yeah,
that.
Yeah, you're being negligent.
Yes. So I needed a pair of headphones that were still, you know, good headphones, stuff that I could exercise with, that I also wouldn't leave in my pocket to wash. So I got these guys. And overall, I love them. I think they're absolutely wonderful.
Mm-hmm.
As far as quality goes, that's a big old, it depends on what you're looking for. Because, because they're bone conducting, you're not going to get, like, earth-shattering bass.
Yeah, or else your bones would shatter.
Right. Your bone-shattering bass. Oh, God damn it, you knocked me out of my crag blade.
Not my crag.
All right.
But, like, if you're, like, watching, like, a movie, can you hear, like, the dialogue?
Oh, yeah. No, like, so it's really good. Even, like, listening to music, it's great. It's just not going to be, like, fuck. Hold on. Oh, I died. Great. It's just not going to be, like, it's not going to be, like, the same as AirPods or over the head.
Sure,
you know,
sure.
You're not going to hear, like, the full depth of it. You hear it great. It sounds really good. Like, if you're listening to an audiobook, you can hear everything very, very clearly.
Yeah.
But it's not like you're not going to get the entire audio range of, you know, the highest highs and lowest lows and all that BS.
Yeah.
Which is fair, because, like, that's not what their purpose is.
Highlander was asking, what were they called? We were calling them bone phones, but what are they actually called?
These are Aftershocks.
Aftershocks
and the ones that
headphones.
I got.
Aftershocks with a Z. Why did they have to do the
yeah,
thing with the Z?
Yeah, they gotta do it with a Z. They're Aftershocks headphones, and I forget which ones these are, but specifically. But yes, overall, what I will say is overall, I highly recommend them. Though, if you want headphones just for listening to, like, the best quality music, you're gonna have a bad time.
Hmm.
Because they're,
okay,
it won't be the best quality music. But if you're just looking for, like, a general pair of headphones, yeah, they're great. The other issue is they don't cover your ear. And so, like, for example, when I wear them when I mow the lawn, I
Oh, you can still hear the lawn mowing.
You can still hear the lawnmower. So they actually come with a pair of what do they call them?
Like earbuds?
Not earbuds. Ear
like noise canceling the little things.
Well, yeah, what do you stick in your ear?
The little putty things, like when you go swimming.
What do you call those? Not earbuds.
Aren't those called earbuds?
Earbuds?
I'm pretty sure those are called earbuds, right?
They're earbuds.
Little ear pluggers?
Earplugs. Earplugs, not earbuds.
Earplugs. Not earpluggers. That's I made that one up. Yeah, everyone in chat knew that they were earplugs.
Yeah, earplugs. Earplugs. So yeah, they come with a pair of I'm full pincushion here. They come with a pair of earplugs just because, like, yeah, if it's too loud, you can't hear shit.
Yeah, I was about to say, every time I'm on my lawn, I listen to podcasts. And yeah. I definitely need to, like, kind of jam my body. I'm like, you guys got to get in there because I don't want to be hearing this lawnmower. It's very loud.
Yes. And so, like, you know, you have to adapt a little bit. But overall, yes, I am very, very happy with them. And I haven't washed them. So, you know, win-win. Overall, I'm
They're not getting weird ear stuff on them. They're only just getting weird bone stuff on them.
That's the other thing. That is the other thing about them, by the way, which is glorious, which is like earbuds you got to clean out every once in a while because, yeah, they'll get your ear gunk in them.
Yeah, that's not good at all.
And that ain't good at all.
Lampy with another 200 bits. Thank you so much, Lampy says. Apparently, they're just called Shocks now, still with a Z. Apparently, they have a new version that has better bass now. Was considering getting some for exercising and when I need to hear what is happening around me. Thanks, Jack. Wanted to hear the opinion from someone who gets audio.
Yeah, no, and by the way, it is also really nice where it's like people can't sneak up on you. You can still like hear it when, you know, something dings. Overall, I'm super, super happy with them. This stream is not sponsored by Aftershocks. But
it's sponsored by Jolly Good Soda.
Oh, that's right. It's sponsored by Jolly Good Soda. You're absolutely right.
Yeah.
But yeah, just know that going in is that you, you know, it's going to sound different. It's not going to be like for audiophiles.
Yeah.
All right.
George Lucas said, give me flack, give me raw. So I don't think it's there for George Lucas if you're looking for that raw flack.
Yeah, if you need that raw flack, this is not your jam.
That also sounds like raw flack sounds like something from like The Wire or Ozarks. I don't know. I'm not sure what raw flack is. I don't like talking about it though. The Wizard of Muna says, "Is this a no-kill run?" It is not a no-kill run. It is, however, a jar kill only, which means the only way we're going to be causing damage primarily is using what's it called, Crag Blade's Fist.
Yep. So this here we go. When you Crag Blade fisted weapons, it turns your fist into rocks, and as you just saw what I did to that Crystal Guardian, it absolutely obliterates everyone. It's honestly just the most fun to use. And so go ahead.
Do you remember Sock'em Boppers?
Rock'em Sock'em Robots?
No, similar to Rock'em Sock'em Robots. They were a toy. Sock'em Boppers. They were these giant boxing gloves you would put on that you filled like with air, like a pool toy.
Mm-hmm.
So you'd put these plastic things on your hands, fill them with air, and then two kids could just beat the shit out of each other. With big inflatable tubes on their hands.
Yes.
And let me tell you, Sock'em Boppers, they hurt. It was like they were sort of like, it was a trick to be like, you can't hurt your friends. It was like, you can absolutely hurt your friends. If you have some of the friends I have, they will hurt you.
Sock'em Boppers.
Wizard of Munoz, they remember that. It had a famous theme song. Sock'em Boppers, Sock'em Boppers, Sock'em Once, Sock'em Twice, More Fun Than a Pillow Fight.
Ooh, More Fun Than a Pillow Fight. That's quite a song.
Yeah.
All right.
I put the link. I keep putting the links to things in the chats that we're talking about. None of this is sponsored by these. None of these are links that we get money for. These are all shit we're bringing up in the moment. they still make Sock'em Boppers, though, so that's good.
That's great. All right, great. All right, we have upgraded our cestuses as much as we can now until we get some more stones. We're going to progress Rodrigo's story here. Okay. And, all right.
So and $1.99 dono from Emmanuel Taribo over on YouTube. Thank you so much, Emmanuel. Says, this run sure will be a jarring experience.
I think it will be a jarring experience, literally.
Oh, my God. These jokes are uncanny. Nope. Are cans and jars the same things?
Yeah, sure.
Yes. Right. Yeah.
Okay, great. That's progressed. All right, so now we will go get our soul jars.
Jars.
Our soul jars of fortune is what we will get next. If you remember, we got them during the explosions only run. This is the catacombs that have all the teleporting bullshit.
Oh yeah.
The teleporting chests. The only good thing about it this time is that we are able to actually fight back without it costing us anything.
That's good. That is good. Yeah, unlike that first time, which wasn't great.
I'm currently editing those streams to see if I can like get it to like a 20-30 minute video of just like explaining the run.
Yeah.
And rewatching that part of it was just frustrating. So like, you know, the magic of editing though will clean it right up.
Daniel Scheinvar says, you should have got a sponsorship from the Container Store. We should have. Nick's in chat. Nick, we have several sponsorships lined up we need to reach out to.
Uh-huh.
Jolly Good Soda Company.
Uh-huh.
Mm-hmm. Shox. The headphones. The bone phones. Sock'em Boppers, which apparently were sued by Mattel and have to be called Soccer Boppers because Sock'em Boppers was too close to Rock'em Sock'em Robots.
Oh. Apparently.
And the Container Store. We still want mm-hmm. all those container sickos to join us.
Container sickos.
Yeah. Yeah. Oh, there's people who, we were talking about that the other week, who love containers. Oh my God. They go to Pier 1 Imports and they get asked to leave because they're being too weird.
It's me. I love containers. I geek out about containers. Most recently, Here's my recent container story. As we make our way up to the Altus Plateau, so we can go get the. Yeah, I can get them. So we can get the Soul Jars of Fortune. So something that most people know about me because I tell them is I have a very particular set of ADHD. One is the general, you know, the inattentive, like that, you know, ADHD, of course you have that. But the other tier of my ADHD, which apparently comes in multiple tiers, which is, something
I didn't know that.
I didn't know before I talked to my therapist about it either. But, the other tier that I have is called, over-focused. Which means that, I can become locked into something so much that, it's hard for me to quite literally focus on anything else. I should get, I don't need that. I should get some rune arcs though. Can I get two? I can get two. Great. Cause we might need those later. And so when I become slightly obsessed with something, it's really hard for me to shake that is basically what it is. It's like, I'll find something interesting. Like the other week it was, e-bikes. It was like battery operated bikes.
I
do not ride bikes, but I I have a bike, but I don't ride bike as a
actively.
But I saw a video about like building your own e-bikes and I became obsessed. And for a solid 5 days, that's all I did was research onto building my own e-bike because that's what my brain told me to do. Luckily, it passed before I purchased anything because they are very expensive.
Also, building your own, I feel like, would be dangerous. I feel like if I tried to build an e-bike, something would explode.
Well,
it would literally blow my balls off while I was riding.
Really, it's just strapping a battery and a motor to your existing bike. In a really fun and a very interesting way, actually. I become obsessed with things. Container Store is where this started.
Yes.
So what my obsession was, I've probably told this story about a past obsession. Oh, excuse. Oh, come on. I aggroed the poison flame guy, and now I can't use my map because he's spewing he's spewing poison at me. Get out of town. All right, great. Are you still aggroed, or can I use my map? I can use my map. Okay, great. So a past obsession of mine that I talked about was getting a split-second stopwatch. I don't know if I've told you about this.
Were these the things you were ordering from the Ukraine?
Yes.
Okay.
The quick recap for anyone who doesn't know. A stopwatch, everyone knows what a stopwatch is.
Yeah.
A mechanical stopwatch is where you can see the hands. Oh, fuck. Hold on. I'm getting knocked off of Torrent by things and such.
By something large and mean.
Something large and mean. A split second stopwatch allows you to have 2 second hands going at once, which I became slightly obsessed with because of my comedy theater. We have referees at the comedy theater, and every once in a while you need to keep track of the greater time of the game, but keep track of it in 15 second intervals.
Yeah.
I don't ref. I don't ref often. I'm only learning how to ref now. So this was not an important thing, but I became obsessed with it. Found all of these being sold from the Ukraine right as the war was starting in the Ukraine. And so after I ordered my first one, all of the ones that I was looking at, all of a sudden I was getting messages from all of these sellers saying, hey, I could really use the money right now because of the war. So if you buy it now, I promise to ship it to you as soon as our post office is functional again. And I currently have.
Oh, you do have them.
Oh, no, I have 12 of them.
That's a lot.
Yes, because then like my obsession mixed with my liberal guilt filter through. And they're not expensive. We're talking like $40, pop. So like they're not expensive. But now I have so many of them. So that's obsession number one.
If you have 12, you can have one for each month. And you can decorate them and be like, oh, this one has a little pumpkin on it because it's the spooky one.
Or visual aids while we're writing up the deck this list. So no, they're glorious. Like they look great. They're
beautiful, wonderful
stopwatches. Like, and this one has like this blue tint on the back, and they're just great.
That's very cool.
They're just great stopwatches. And so recently, over at the comedy theater, I have been starting to ref more and more. When refing is a very very tough job, and it's a really difficult learned skill. Great, now I have my stopwatch and I got my whistle. So after my first time reffing, what I realized is this stopwatch, by the way, is a half a pound. That's very, very
heavy. That's a hefty stopwatch.
That's a heavy, heavy stopwatch.
You put a couple of those in a sock and you could bludgeon a man who's intruding on your home.
Absolutely. We need something here. There is a cloud of dust near here. There is a hidden scarab near here that we need for a weapon that we might use later.
So we didn't know this.
Yeah. So we got to keep our eye out for a cloud of dust. So in any case, I have it around my neck and it's very, very heavy. And anytime I move, because obviously, you're running around a fair bit while reffing.
Yeah, on the venue. Yeah, I can imagine that.
And so, I don't know where it is. It doesn't matter, I guess. So it's like, I have this big heavy thing around my neck and it's not working great, right? So I'm thinking to myself, it would be great if I had like a little holster for my stopwatch, like on my hip. Then I could pull out my stopwatch when I need it, holster it when I need it, no problem. So again, these are my fun obsessive natures. And so that became my daily obsession, is finding just the right holster. Now it says to look for a cloud of dust.
Just the right holster. It's like people who used to get those big fat cell phone holsters.
Yes. Well, yeah. So I was looking actually for old beeper holsters.
Okay. Yeah.
It's just like something that would be the right side. What? Was this it? Try behind.
Hubba hubba.
Hubba hubba. Patch of dirt. Is it around here? Try circling around and then behind.
Is it invisible?
It's invisible. There is an invisible scarab around here that does not make any noise.
Oh, that sounds like a nuisance.
Yes, and apparently you're supposed to see a little cloud of dust, and it's for an earth slam ash of war that fits with the warrior jar's movements.
Oh, yeah, I can see that working out.
And so I don't even know if I'll end up using it just because the Crag Blade works so well, but I'd love to have it as an option.
Yeah. Oh, and I missed earlier, Lampy, with another 100 cheers. Thank you so much. Said, don't forget the Pizzazz sponsorship and the funding goal of the band Deebs. Deebs has already been to band, so it's fine. So rest in peace, Deebs. We knew him well. Also, I just noticed that you've added extra jars to the overlay.
Of course.
Did you add? Did you get a sneaky one in there?
I got a jar under you now.
Yeah. Oh my God. So many jars. Yeah. It looks like it's like a spittoon. Like I could. But then I would just like spit on my carpet, which wouldn't be great.
Yeah. Don't spit on your carpet.
Yeah.
Where are we going? Oh, that's right. We're going up here. Right. So I need a holster, and so like then this just turns into research, where it's like this is my time now. All my free time goes to researching the absolutely correct holster for my stopwatch. I found stuff that was close because apparently they make a tape measure holster for contractors.
Oh, I can imagine that. Yeah.
Right. And so it's like, oh, it's just close enough, but tape measure is pretty darn thick. My stopwatch is pretty darn thin. And so that's not going to work. Oh, but they have some vintage ones that are pretty good, but, oh, you know, shipping and, oh, those are expensive because they're made out of leather and blah, 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 blah. So the Container Store is where this came from. I swear this is related to the Container Store. not necessarily the Container Store, but containers in general. And so then my wife had an idea, mostly to get me out of my spiral, because she knows what these can do. It's like, oh, you know what? We have two stores in the Milwaukee area that are perfect for bizarro containers. One is American Science and Surplus, which, if you've never been, hey, sponsorship opportunity.
There you go. Nick, put it down.
American
Nick, and then Nick keeps saying, go tell John that. And I'm like, John's not in John's not in the comments right now. You're in the comments, Nick.
Right? American Science and Surplus, which has a bunch of really rando, bizarro, like sciencey, and, of course, military surplus supplies. So we went there first and we didn't find anything, but then we also have Sherpers, and Sherpers is a camping, hunting, and military surplus store over in Hale's Corners, which is a phenomenal store, and they have like a million bags and packs, and like it's mostly for guns and like gun-like vests, but just a ton of really wonderful like bags and packs and accessories, and of course if you're into camping, it's a great camping store as well. But what I ended up finding, hold on, we're going to run away from Margit. Where is it? Oh, here it is. So this is an accessory for a tactical vest, like a bulletproof vest.
Okay, like a little pouch that you could put on it.
This is a little pouch that you can put on your bulletproof vest, and it's a cell phone holder for your bulletproof vest that goes on the outside of your bulletproof vest, by the way, which I don't think you want to put your cell phone there.
No, that's too bad.
Just putting that out there. But as it turns out, here, let me rest of this side of grace. As it turns out, like, I need to modify it a little bit. But look at this. The pocket watch.
Ooh, doggy. Snug in a rug. There.
And then, like, it's got, like, a belt loop on this side. And so it's like, oh, look at this. Like, you know, I added this little keychain ring to it. So I can easily pull it out, holster it. Look at that. Beauty.
Beautiful. You're going to be so quick on the draw.
It's, and you know why? Because I love containers. I love things that you put other things in. I just love things that you put other things in.
Yeah, things are fine, but things you put things in, ooh, doggy.
Oh, man. Oh, you mean I can put my things in another thing? That makes it easier to obtain my things?
I love it, yeah. Do you have a conniption fit when you see those Russian nesting dolls?
Oh, you know what? No, I'm okay with the Russian nesting dolls.
Wow.
I'm okay with
them. Not crazy about them? But they're like little dolls inside other little dolls.
Yeah, but those aren't things. Those are dolls. Those are like toys. Like, that's not a thing. That's not a stuff.
It's not stuff. I feel like it's stuff.
Yeah.
It's not stuff.
I don't know.
It's not a tchotchke. You're all about those tchotchkes.
I do like tchotchkes. That's not my kind of stuff.
Have you gotten into like what's going on with your whistle game? You mentioned a whistle earlier.
I mentioned a whistle earlier.
Yeah, you said like when you're reffing, you have
Well,
you
yeah,
have a whistle and you have a.
I got a regular whistle. It's just a regular.
Are there like cool kinds of whistles? Like, is there like genres of whistles?
First of all, Jeebus Crisp. There are so many. There are so many whistles. I don't need anything from you. There are what I thought would be neat. The other thing I got. Oh.
I think I've only blown a whistle probably 4 times in my life.
I think I've had
like anxiety every time beforehand. So I don't think I want to blow a whistle anymore.
Like, I think everyone understands that whistles are loud, but whistles are really loud.
They're very loud. And they got that rattling inside of it. I never know. Is that like a child's tooth? What is that?
That's what makes the whistle noise. That's what rotates the air in such a way to create the whistle.
Is it a tooth? Is it a youth tooth?
Well, I guess in mine, I had to bring my own tooth. But luckily I have kids. So I just, popped one right out.
It's a child's tooth. Yeah. Okay. That makes sense.
It's 100% a child's tooth. Yeah. Whistles. I have an ordinary whistle. But the other pouch that I got. Wait, how do I get down? Oh, here it is. The other pouch that I got because I thought it would be fun is this. I got a magazine holster. You know, like this guy, right here.
Like guns. I was thinking for like I got this old issue of Nintendo Power in the mail today, and I thought we'd be able to hold that.
A holster for Nintendo Power? No, like for gun magazines. Because the other thing I think might be really neat is, in comedy sports, you can call fouls on players and on audience members. And so I thought, there's a couple.
Like handing them like red cards?
I thought flags would be more fun, like to throw.
That'd be great. The little weighted flags.
Flag,
oh my God, you could throw in that.
And so I, what I found, and there is a ref, there's a ref right now who uses flag, or who has like a flag tucked into their belt, but they very rarely use it.
Yeah, yeah.
Crap, running away. Oh my God. Hold on. Got to get away from the bear. Nope.
Too many bears.
Crap. Too many bears. So I thought it would be fun if I got some flags and put them in the magazine holster to whip out and throw. But I don't know if that will work yet. We're going to.
So, I love it though.
But so I was looking for flags. I was looking for nice quality weighted flags. I clicked over to their whistle section on like a specifically like referee in referee stores.
Okay.
And man, the amount of whistles that they staggering.
If you're a referee for like a certain amount of years, do you think they give you like, oh, this is your silver anniversary, so you get a silver whistle? And
they have whistles with specific bite grip, so you can like keep a whistle like biting it in your teeth with like a soft foamy so you can bite it, so you can keep it in your teeth at all times. It's
incredible.
They have electronic whistles.
Well, how does that work?
I have no idea. It has different whistle tones. You can like you blow into it and then it amplifies a sound so you don't have to use as much air perhaps.
Okay.
They have ring whistles so you don't have to hold a whistle around your neck. You can have it on your hand and just go doot and then still like have your fingies free, but it's like a ring.
Yeah.
It's a ring whistle. Amazing.
Do they have in Mario 3 he had a warp whistle? Are those real?
100%.
Okay.
100%.
So they just take like a gust of wind comes by and takes you to another land?
Takes you to another land. The only problem is if your passport is not up to snuff, you never know
where. Oh, that could be terrible. You'd end up like Tom Hanks in the terminal.
Exactly.
You'd be a man who can't leave the airport. Oh, that'd be a bummer.
That would be a bummer. So no one wants to do it because you never know where you're going to end up.
No, that's really rolling the die.
Yeah.
Simple Simon, speaking of rolling the die. He rolled a die and got a 5 because it's a $5 donation from Simple
Simon.
I don't understand what that means. This stopwatch story seems like it's actually a secret Norm MacDonald moth joke. I eagerly await the punchline that will likely never come. Nope. R.I.P. Norm.
No.
Norm MacDonald's incredible.
Norm MacDonald was and continues to be incredible, yes.
Absolutely astounding. Mm.
All right, yes, we are just about to Soul Jars of Fortune. So actually, yeah, let's do that. Let's do Soul Jars of Fortune. We are here. Cragblade up so we can actually
I'm going to look up whistles.
Look up. Yeah, there's a bunch of really amazing whistles.
I would want to get a whistle that its noise is just a stern first name. And so it's like a whistle, but it just comes out as like Timothy. it's a whistle, and I not even necessarily like for a specific person, but just, oh man, you could buy whistles in bulk.
Timothy.
Oh my god. I would love you could buy all sorts of colorful whistles.
Yeah,
like 12 packs for $12.
No, and I have a simple plastic red whistle because I got them in bulk too, because yeah, I can only assume I'm gonna mess them up. So like my whistle's fairly simple. My stopwatch game though is unmatched.
Yeah.
The real thing about the stopwatch is a lot of referees currently use their cell phone as a stopwatch.
Yeah.
And to me, then you just have someone who is looking at their cell phone during the show. And while
that's not great.
Well, you know, and it's like, I get it. They're looking at their watch on their phone app, but it's still looking at their phone. So I didn't want to be a person that would look at their phone.
We look at our phones enough.
Yeah.
All week. So it's nice. It's nice to have a reason not to look at it.
Agreed.
I found on Amazon, it's $35, but it's currently 19% off, which isn't bad. A screaming Aztec death whistle in obsidian black.
I'm sorry.
Yeah. I'm definitely tossing this in the chat. Are you kidding me, chat? It looks old and worn. Like, it looks like something some archaeologist would find in the first act of a movie, which would lead to their demise in the third act of said movie.
That sounds like exactly what
for the about this item, it says authentic Aztec design, stone cast ceramic, handcrafted, and terrifying screams. What does that mean?
I mean, is there a thing where you can hear the scream? Hold on.
Oh, does Amazon have like a...
Hold on, wait. I'm clicking over here. What is it called?
I just put it in either of the chats. Screaming Aztec death whistle.
Okay, let's see if you guys can hear this.
Hey everyone, this is Z. I'm here with First Nations Music. They're super creepy.
Do y'all hear that?
Super high pitched.
I hear a woman talking.
Okay, ready?
Super creepy, super loud, and we have a couple of different ones just to try out for you today.
Listen.
As you can see,
that's horrifying.
Oh, I think your mic cut it out for me.
Oh, okay. Hopefully the chat heard that. Oh, sure, because that would be like one sustained note that Discord would think is noise. But it sounds like this.
No, I don't like that. I don't like that at all. Yeah, yeah. I'm gonna. How do I delete the screaming death whistle from my Amazon search history?
That's all you're gonna get now is death whistle recommendations.
Oh, folks in chat said they heard it. Can I hear it? Oh no! I just turned down the noise on chat or on the stream, and it was just you making the noise again. Oh, yeah.
First of all, you're welcome.
Still good enough.
Oh damn it! I Cragbladed too early.
Lampy also with another 200 bits. Thank you so much, Lampy. Says bring back Jack's soundbox. Jack, did you have a soundbox?
I had a little sound maker that I would bust out when streaming with Nick, and Nick found it incredibly annoying. Which is very, very fair, by the way. What did we bet? We bet something, and if I was wrong, I had to destroy my sound box. And turns out,
Nick just types "smashed" in all caps with an exclamation point in the chat. Did you have to smash it?
I did. I smashed it.
What was the bet,
Nick? What was our bet? Do you remember that part?
Also, chat thinks that the death whistle sounded like the blood-starved beast from Bloodborne.
It did. You know what? I bet they might have used a similar sound.
Pure Byro says, you bet Sony's PS5 announcements? Does that sound familiar?
Could be.
Nick said it was how many game reveals we guessed in the PlayStation showcase.
Oh, right, right.
But Nick probably goes to his, he goes to his editor-in-chief luncheons.
Yeah.
Where all the fancies, you know, drink chamomile with a pinky out and discuss all the hot goss that's coming up the next week. So he probably knew.
Right. So yeah. What you're saying is it wasn't fair.
It wasn't fair. Nick should have to rebuild your soundbox.
I mean, I got more.
You buy everything in dozens.
Yeah.
You buy everything by the dozens.
Cheap.
Fate says, what was Nick's penalty if he lost? Would he have to burn his hat?
Yeah, it was something like that, or like Halo, or yeah, it was something. I forget. It was Halo or something.
He has to kill the Master Chief.
Mm-hmm.
That it's that Wesley Snipes crying with the gun image. Yeah,
exactly.
Beast Marsh with a $5 donation. Thank you so much, Beast Marsh. First, excellent 3MR today. Thank you so much, Beast Marsh. You guys can check out my 3-minute review on the new Saints Row game available tomorrow on consoles near you. My review is that the game is pretty forgettable.
Forgettable?
Pretty forgettable. I think in 2 weeks' time, I'll forget everything about it. You know what? I didn't hate my time in the game. It doesn't do anything new. You could have told me this game was made in 2012. I would have believed you. You could have told me this game would have been made in 2006. I would have believed you.
Oh,
It does have a DMX song in the soundtrack, though, so.
What? That's stop.
Great. He does a lot of burking.
Where the Rough Riders roll.
Whoa. Beast Marsh also said, 2, thank you for more Elden Ring content. You're very welcome. And 3, I beat Loretta in Mikala's Helga tree, so have some cash.
Ooh.
Listen, if you're in the Haggle tree, that's just fucking hell. Whatever that place is called, I hate it. I hate it there, and I don't like it there.
Hallig. I believe.
Hallig?
Hallig tree, yeah.
Haguli?
Mastacholi tree.
Oh, my. That sounds delicious.
Oh, a whole tree of mastacholi.
Except I always associate mastacholi as funeral food, because when I was young, I had a bunch of relatives die, because they were all old, as older people tend to do. Uh-huh. And we would always have funerals at the same cemetery, same church, and then we would go to this banquet hall across the street. And I just remember they would always serve mastacholi. And it was a span of a couple of years where I just kept having relatives die. And so I kept having that funeral mastacholi.
Oh.
So now, to me, mastacholi is like oranges in The Godfather. Like, it portends death.
Gotcha. Yeah.
Which sucks, because let me tell you, I enjoy mastacholi.
Who doesn't?
Yeah.
Who doesn't enjoy a little mastacholi?
Did you know that's Italian for the master's choli? So that's how you know it's like incredibly good, because not only is it choli, but it's the master's choli.
The master's choli. I don't believe you is what I'm going to say.
Sound off in the comments below.
Where the Rough Riders roll.
What if that's how it ends? Whoa. Sound off in the comments below. Maybe that's what that song is about.
Very possible.
Eve said, how do you spell? How do I spell master choli? I actually don't know how to spell master choli.
Is this where I go?
Well, this is how you spell normal mastacholi. Yeah, mastacholi is just like what is it, like like lasagna for cowards?
yeah, basically.
I actually think it's a much more manageable lasagna. I think lasagna is like New Game Plus.
Yeah, this is easy mode lasagna, which is not that's not necessarily a once again, you know, like easy modes. It's not a bad thing, because it's
I think it's great.
Like, literally all spaghetti is the same thing, where it's like it's carbs, sauce, and cheese in a certain arrangement, and no one's complaining about their arrangements.
Yeah, but like whether you're rolling like a corkscrew noodle or an elbow noodle or a ziti.
Yeah.
Get out of here. It's all the same.
Get out of here. First of all, get out of here. It just matters for like sauce absorption, right? Where it's like, what's the best noodle to fit the amount of sauce that I'm putting in?
Yeah. Yeah, that is true. You know what? I've gotten big in angel hair pasta.
Oh, yeah.
It's like spaghetti, but real thin.
But like real thin.
It's real thin. Yeah. American Fierce says bow tie for the win.
Nothing
that's
wrong.
What FTW is, for the win, right?
Yeah.
It's not fuck the world. Okay, for the win.
Fuck the world. Fuck the world.
Bow tie pasta, fuck the world.
Fuck the world, pasta. Listen here, pasta brothers. It's time to fuck the world. Fuck the world away. Fuck the
Mario
world
and
away.
Luigi here. Welcome to Super Nintendo Land. Storm Templar says I'm a rotini man myself. Rotini. Oh, look at you.
Well, first of all, you know, that's not polite to say about yourself.
Yeah, you shouldn't kiss and tell.
I've had girls tell me I'm a rotini man. Once again, even though we just did this goddamn thing, and I just edited this section of the last run, I have no idea where I am or what I'm doing or where I'm supposed to go. We just
Is this the one where you have to ride the thing upwards?
No, this is the one where you have to find the right chest to transport you to the right area to flip the switch.
Mm-hmm.
And I have no goddamn idea where I'm supposed to go. Fuck. Well, at least I found another one of these things.
Dingus says, the penne is mightier than the sword. I think that's great. I think that's beautiful, actually.
Dare I say beautiful? I did.
What's your favorite noodle? Do you got a favorite noodle?
I don't. I don't have a favorite noodle. Okay. Because I find them all to be incredibly interchangeable.
Yeah.
I
agree.
And so, like, you know, this is no, I'm not disrespecting my pot brothers. Stop striking me. I am one of you. Can't you see?
Queen of the One Ring asks, how do you feel about these puzzle dungeons?
This one in particular is a bit much.
Yeah, I like the other one we were talking about better, the one where the solution is to ride the blade up. Because once you get the solution, you're kind of like, oh, shit, I should have been observant. These games are all about being observant, and yes. I wasn't being observant.
And this one... Oh, haha. This one just definitely seems a little bit more like a fuck you.
Yeah.
I think, in general, my cop-out answer is variety is important.
Yeah.
And I'm glad that they do mix it up, and it's not just run around the same dungeon. So it's like, okay, yeah, they did something different. This is a memorable dungeon because of how terrible it is. Booty.
I would have liked to see more. I would have liked to see them expand on the puzzle aspect in the same way that certain shrines in Breath of the Wild have really memorable kind of puzzle design.
Mm.
I'm sorry for bringing up
I think that's apples oranges. I'll be honest with you. Because
this is true.
Breath of the Wild gives you traversal tools. And Elden Ring does not give you traversal tools. It only gives you combat tools. So
it gives you a horse that's not allowed to enter inside because horses are not allowed in hospitals.
But there's a horse in the hospital. right. And so it's like, I think that's a little unfair comparison. And that is the pigeonhole that Elden Ring places on itself when we talk about kind of like telling its gameplay through the lens of violence.
Yeah, it doesn't have the verbs necessary for sort of platforming and mental puzzles.
Yeah,
it's got invisible walls sometimes. Those are neat.
Hell yeah!
You crack one of those and you're like, oh shit, that wall's not real. Pure Power says, I prefer these dungeons to how the Chalice dungeons unfolded. Yeah, I wasn't crazy about the Chalice dungeons, if I'm being honest.
Hundreds.
I like that it was more Bloodborne.
Yes.
I'd rather just replay Bloodborne at that point.
All right, now I have to be careful because... Oh, there it is. Yeah, so at any moment, like I have to be very aware of when my crag blade falls off because I'm trying very, very hard to only hit the enemy when I have Craig Blade on.
Yeah.
Or else it doesn't count.
Yeah, we can't hit him without Craig's Blade. Also, it seems like this dungeon should have had... The boss of this dungeon should have been like a real trickster who's like, nah, I've been teleporting you, but then it's just a large man with two hammers.
Yeah,
like, you're the opposite of a trickster. You're just a brute. You're a fruit brute.
Yes, I agree with you there. Here's the lore we can put on it. How about this? Is we know that jars are hunted.
They are, yeah.
Jars are hunted by the perfumers, because the living jar shards are what perfumers use in some of their concoctions. And so, like, later on, the people, you know, the poachers that get Jarberg are presumably perfumers. Mm-hmm. And so what we can think here is that this is a living jar sanctuary, and they've put all of these maze-like traps here to protect remaining living jars.
Gotcha. And so this man's their defender?
Sure. Yeah, let's say that. We are going to get slightly more aggressive this time. I think I was playing it a little too cautiously before.
George Lucas says George Jar Jar Martin. That's a lot of references in one goof. George Lucas. George Jar Jar Martin. Speaking of George R.R. Martin, I hope everyone saw the announcement that tomorrow we're going to be launching our brand new entertainment live podcast called The Recap. We'll be live at 11 a.m. Central. We're going to be having rotating casts every week, but this week it will be myself, Nick Calandra, and the incredible Darren Mooney talking about the premiere of House of the Dragon. We talk a little bit about She-Hulk, maybe even talking a little bit about He-Hulk. Who knows?
All the Hulks. This man can...
There's a lot of Hulks.
Can one-shot me.
He's angry. He's very angry.
He's angry. We did better that time, but he can one-shot me, so we have to be very, very careful here. I still have yet to watch... I know She-Hulk just came out last week, so I'm not too worried. I have not seen She-Hulk yet. I know the discourse around it is already insufferable.
Sure.
But you know, that's pretty normal. So,
yes, yeah.
So I'm not going to sweat about that too much.
Lampy with another 100 bits says, Weeb Shit Show finally. Woo. And I guess other stuff too. Hell yeah. This will also be our vessel for Weeb Shit. I got so many ideas for Weeb Shit. Oh my God. We have so many ideas. We'll bring Jack on it. Whenever Jack gives a shit about something. We got an open seat for Jack. If Jack wants to chat,
about
a cool movie, about a cool TV show.
There is often
Hocus Pocus 2 is coming soon.
There are many a times in which I actually do give a shit about things.
That's what we want this. We don't want this to be gun to your head. You got to talk about like the fucking the Fafnir cameo at the end of Guardians of the Galaxy 3.
Right.
No, this is like, you know, you excited to talk about the weird Marilyn Monroe movie, Rated X? Hell yeah. Let's come on here and talk about the X-rated Marilyn Monroe movie. This new Fletch movie? Do you know there's a new Fletch movie coming out?
Oh, actually, I don't know if you know this. I'm a huge Fletch fan.
I didn't know that, but I kind of thought you would be.
I've read all the Fletch novels, including the Son of Fletch novels.
Incredible.
Which are and you know none of them are as good as the first Fletch novel. Fletch is a goddamn masterpiece.
Oh my God. So where are you? What's your temperature? On this new one, John Hamm plays Fletch.
First
John Hamm of
yes.
Mad Men.
Yes, I love that.
Directed by Greg Mottola, who directed Superbad and Adventureland.
Interesting. I'm one of those people. Like I'm in the minority of people who absolutely. Oh my God! I'm so glad he missed me. Who absolutely hated Chevy Chase's Fletch movie.
Interesting.
Mostly because it completely bastardized one of my favorite books.
I guess that'll do it, yeah.
So... Nope! Oh, fuck. Oh. I tried to do a jump and move on him. He did a jumping move on me. Fletch is an absolutely amazing book. Fletch is so amazing that even though all of the sequels to the Fletch novels are relatively subpar, like or par. They're all like par to subpar, some better than others, some worse than others. But the character of Fletch is so good and so well established in that first novel that the momentum carries over through all subsequent work, even in the Son of Fletch novels. In fact, do I have them here?
In fact, we have Chevy Chase shackled in Jack's basement right now.
Oh no! I'm just like I have some books on my shelf, not my Fletch collection, but I will bring out my Fletch collection for when we talk about the new Fletch movie because I have
we're gonna be Fletching out.
I have many many things to say about Fletch. I'm a Fletch head. Big old Fletch.
Yeah, you got your Fletch light at home. That's just like a lamp that you put on when you want to read a Fletch book.
Jesus.
A couple people in chat are shocked that Fletch wasn't just a movie but was a series of books, which I think is pretty normal. I don't think the books have. I think the movie is more popular than the books. I would say more people know of the Chevy Chase movie than know of the books. Maybe.
Oh yeah.
Yeah.
Oh yeah, no. And by the way, the find yourself a copy of Fletch, the book, and you will have a wonderful time. It's especially if you are a fan of like detective novels, mysteries, like it's
and like Elmore Leonard kind of stuff.
Oh my God, he didn't even hit me and he killed me.
He's so rude. Why is he so rude?
This is a tricky one without wearing armor. It's a tricky old fight without wearing it. And that's okay because we're here for the soul jars and we're going to get them. We're going to get them. Wait, what does my physic do again? I might need to rethink my physic. Fletch is too similar sounding to Felch? I don't know what Felch is.
Oh, that's a gross sex thing. You said a gross sex thing.
Yeah. Oh, that's why.
Oh, Mahaven.
That's why. What is this?
That got Felching got brought up on Slay Something Else today too. What is happening? Why are we doing this? Why am I the common denominator here?
And why are you the common denominator?
But I think it was Yahtzee who brought it up.
There we go. I just remembered that in my mixed physic, I had the thing that gives me extra iframes, but also makes me take extra damage.
That's not good.
So we're going to swap that out for stamina regen, and hopefully that will make this fight a little easier to manage.
Dingus says, does Fletch compare to Raymond Chandler? Because his books are Detective Gold. Have you ever read Raymond Chandler?
I have not. So
I'm a big fan of Raymond Chandler. Is Fletch like are the books like silly? Are they serious? Are they funny?
They are a wonderful mix of. Okay. I think the reason that like Chevy Chase wanted to do it is because like Fletch is the kind of character that Chevy Chase wishes he was. Whereas like
sure.
Like a little comedy, a little serious. Like, you know, Fletch is he's a rogue. He's your Han Solo type.
Yeah.
You know, thief with a heart of gold kind of situation. Mm-hmm. And so I think that's why Chevy liked the idea of Fletch. Nope. But Chevy is, you know, not a good actor. And they tried to turn that movie into too much of a comedy.
They did. That's I think it tried to lean heavily into
what
Chase was doing at the time.
Exactly. And so like just absolutely bastardized it. So yeah, by the way, it was the physic. The physic was killing me far too fast. So now we have the Soul Jars of Fortune.
Heck,
boom.
Yeah. Pride and Balls asked, do you have to fight this guy? No, this is a completely optional boss, but the Soul Jars of Fortune are the only summon that
that we can use.
Makes sense for our jar boy.
Absolutely. So now we have our Soul Jars of Fortune, who, you know, if you remember, are a bad summons. They are bad. They are quite possibly like the worst summon that you can get in this game. But they are also the only summon that I.
That's what they said about the Bad News Bears, and then they won the World Series. I don't know if that's how that movie ends.
The World Series of Baseball?
The Bad News Bears?
Yeah.
Wasn't that a baseball movie?
That was a Little League movie. Little League.
Yeah. Did they not win the World's their children in that? I'm gonna be honest, I don't remember much about the Bad News Bears. I remember there was a remake with Billy Bob Thornton, who I think is wonderful. Oh, and then I was getting that movie confused with the prison football movie. Also a remake with Adam Sandler, The Longest Yard.
The Longest Yard, yeah.
Yeah. Those aren't children, though. Those are criminals.
Those are criminals, yeah. Yeah. No, that's fine. That's fair. That's fine. That's fair. What is it? 4 o'clock? Oh, we're doing great. We're doing great. We're going to go see if we can get some glove warts to raise up our soul jars of fortune. And then I guess let's start with, I don't know, maybe Rinala. Maybe Rinala, maybe Radon. I don't know. I don't know how we're feeling here. I don't know how we're feeling.
How do you, do you gauge one as more difficult than the other?
I'm going to assume that Radon is going to be harder. So maybe let's do Rinala first.
Okay, perfect.
Okay, great. Soul jars, I have no grape glove warts. Okay, great. So yeah, I think, what do we need here? We need this thing. Did I do the thing yet? No, I have not. So let's do Rinala first because she has very little poise. And with our Crag Blade Ash of War, we do bonus poise damage.
Ooh, and she's gonna get the vapors during this fight.
Exactly, in her second phase. We should be able to really take her out rather quickly. Oh, also, yeah. It should be noted in the downtime from the stream, I did do some farming for the items for Exalted Flesh because we did say that we should try to use that as much as possible.
Yeah.
The one thing that I didn't realize about Exalted Flesh is that it uses Arteria Leaf. That red leaf that you find sometimes.
Oh, yeah.
That, like, everyone says is very useless because it mostly is useless.
But it's used in the Exalted Flesh?
It's used in Exalted Flesh. And here's the weird thing about our Arteria Leaf that I didn't know is it doesn't respawn. There's no farming points. There is a set number in the game, much like the Mikola's Lily. Or the
interesting.
Or that the Sleeping Flower. There's a set number in the world, which is bullshit. Which is bullshit.
So what, the only way to get more would be New Game Plus?
Uh-huh, uh-huh. Yeah, the only way to get more is New Game Plus or have someone, like, trade you.
That's hogwash.
I think.
That's what that is.
Yeah.
Large amount of hogwash.
Large amount of hogwash. And so, basically, I farmed for... You need bones, flesh, and... Another thing. Oh, and the berry. So I farmed for bones, flesh, and berry. And then every time we come across an Arteria Leaf, we can make another one. Because those are hard to come by. So
delicious.
Just wanted full disclosure.
Heck yeah.
Yeah.
A little while ago, Queen of the One Ring asked, do you watch Vati Vidya's videos? I do. I think his videos are great. He just put up one recently, a little lore video on the Frenzied Flame.
That's right. I've yet to see that one, but I have watched his videos, in the past. And I think they're great.
He's also, I like his voice, which is important. I think important for video essays, like it's someone's voice.
It's important for any sort of video.
Yeah, yeah.
I talk with Yahtzee a lot about stuff like that. We have, when we stream together, we've also talked about like someone's ability to banter. in videos like this or their cadence or their conversational speech, all this stuff is natural for some but a learned skill for others.
Absolutely. Mm-hmm. My first it's like maybe it's the Michael Jordan 10,000 hours thing. My first 10,000 hours of streaming, I was a shivering mess.
Ooh, I like it that it's explicitly shivering.
It was terrible. I think on the very first podcast I was ever on, I think I could hear me quivering.
Wait.
I could hear me.
Shivering and quivering, I believe, are two different things.
Yeah. Well, the podcast, I was all horned up, so that's why I was... No, shivering and quivering. No. Quivering in fear. Shivering and cold. They're both iverings, right?
They are both iverings. You are correct. Okay. We're going to need...
I'm going to do a Google.
We need a linguist.
Difference between shivering and quivering. Quiver suggests a slight, rapid, and tremulous movement.
Mm.
Her lip quivered like that of a child about to cry.
Yes.
Shiver involves a rapid trembling as of a person experiencing a chill. As I, in hoary winter night, stood shivering in the snow. I think they're similar-ish.
They're similar, but quiver, I guess, is a smaller unit of measurement. So you wouldn't say your body, like, if you said your body quivered, that sentence implies a specific part of the body is quivering, a.k.a. loins.
I feel like the quivering, if I was just listening to the podcast, I would hear the quivering. Whereas if I saw me, I would see the shivering.
Ooh, okay. All right. I like where this is going.
Regardless, it only took 9,999 more hours for me to be less terrible. So
you did it.
If I could do it, anyone can do it.
If you can make it there, you can make it anywhere.
Yeah. NY, the Big Apple. City that don't sleep.
This is a city that doesn't sleep. You know, I don't like Frank Sinatra.
Wow. What about the rest of the Beantown boys?
That's my hot take.
What about Dean Martin? What about Sammy Davis Jr.?
I like Dean Martin.
I love Dean Martin.
I like Dean Martin. I don't like Sinatra's thing. I don't like his whole thing. He's got a whole thing, don't like it.
you know what I bet Sinatra has strong opinions on?
Huh.
Mastacholi.
Mastacholi?
Yeah.
100%.
George Lucas says no one likes Frank Sinatra except snobs. That's not true. Liking Frank Sinatra is not a snobby thing.
No, every grandpa in existence likes Frank Sinatra.
Yeah.
Every single grandpa that has ever existed likes
Frank Sinatra. I do think he's just a poor man's Dean Martin.
Yeah.
Yeah.
100%. These are all ghost glove warts. I need grave glove warts.
Simon says, is the stream glitching for anyone or just my internet? Might be just you, because I have it open here and it seems fine to me. So
yeah, we're getting a pretty stable OBS gives us kind of the stats for our outward connection, and we're in the greens, so it might be you. You know, it might not
maybe be. your ISP got so upset at the Frank Sinatra slander, they just wanted to shut this whole thing down.
So talking smack about Frank Sinatra.
Old Mickey Blue Eyes.
The Bronx bully.
The Bronx bully.
I mean, he was a bully, right?
He was a bully, but he also got bullied. Like, he was a bully, but he was in the first Godfather movie, the actor who is sort of like roughed up for being a little coward,
mm-hmm.
is a Frank Sinatra facsimile.
Oh, okay.
And if it's in The Godfather, it's got to be right. That's my second Godfather reference to the show, guys. If I do it one more time, Marlon Brando is going to come out of the mirror, and it's going to be spooky. No. Also, you know who's a really bad kisser? Al Pacino. Al Pacino, and every time he kisses in a movie... Oh, I don't know it from experience. I've never kissed Al Pacino.
There we go.
But every time he kisses in a movie, he looks like a real bad, real sloppy, wet kisser. It's like kissing like an excited dog. Like Yahtzee was kissing Toffee earlier today. It looked like that.
Good to know. You know, passionate. Al Pacino's a passionate kisser.
Yeah.
Is probably what you meant to say. That's how I'm going to take it.
Yeah. Passionate. Sometimes you can have a little too much passion.
A little too much slop.
Yeah. Oh, yeah. He becomes like a KFC famous bowl of kissing, where they slop too much of the mashed potatoes, then they put the tenders and the corn and the gravy and the cheese. That's what his kisses are like.
Wow.
Yeah,
I'm more impressed by your knowledge of KFC bowls.
It was a big deal. I'm not a big fast food guy, but I get excited when one announces like we're changing the game up, guys. We're really gonna fuck shit up. Like McDonald's just announced that they're bringing, which is apparently a big hit in the UK. It's a Big Mac, but with chicken patties instead of instead of burgers.
What?
So it's like a big, it's like a double-decker chicken sandwich.
I don't, that does not sound.
I'm not going to eat it. I just like its existence. I feel safer knowing that it's there at night.
That's fair.
Yeah.
That's fair. I, you know what? If they're thin chicken patties, I could be down with it, I think.
Yeah, I think McDonald's chicken patties are pretty thin, right? Yeah. I don't think they don't do anything thick at McDonald's.
Only their customers.
Oh, hey!
You burnt.
Bippity bippity bop.
Wait a
Speaking
minute.
Speaking of, Amrao with a $2 donation says, is it fat Marlin? Because young Marlin is a babe. Young Marlon Brando is a babe.
Did you bibbity bibbity bop?
Someone? Yeah, what was the name of that guy? The bad stand-up comedian, Hickory Dickory Dock. Andrew Dice Clay.
Andrew Dice Clay. Hey, old mother okay. cupboard. Old mother Hubbard went to her cupboard to give her old dog a bone. She bent over and Rover took over, gave her a bone of his own. Hey, ho, ho, go, hey, ho.
Genuinely awful. He was in a serious movie recently, and he was good in it. What was that?
Genuinely.
Was he in like a fucking Star Is Born or something?
I don't know.
What was he in? If I was Andrew Dice Clay. Yeah, he was it. He was in A Star Is Born.
What is happening? We are reciting Andrew Dice Clay jokes. That is what is happening. Duh.
Yeah. Yeah. Get with it. Get with the program, Pride and Balls.
Get with the program. All right. I need to
know. Lampy with another pair of 100 biddies.
Biddies.
One. As if Marty says any person's name three times, they come out of his broken closet. That would be scary. Because there's not a lot of room in that closet. So if they were hiding in there the whole time, that's rough for them. And then also, the chicken Big Mac was so big in the UK that it sold out almost everywhere. Yes, they are thin chicken, and it's delicious. Look at that. Man on the ground. We got a reporter. We got eyes in the sky.
I
can't say man on the ground and eyes in the sky. Those are separate. You can only be one or the other.
I'm just going to have to believe you here. I'm just going to have to believe you. All right, hold on. We got to look up something here.
Okay.
We need some grave glove warts. Is what we need here. To upgrade our dang soul jars of fortune.
Heck yeah.
Tombs word count.
Eve Daly with a €2 donation said these streams stopwatches and Al Pacino kisses.
That's all you get.
That's pretty much all you're gonna get. Also Masaccioli. So you guys learned something about Italy. That'll be our new. Speaking of Italy, that'll be the new segment.
You're welcome, everyone. Is what we're saying. All right, we're gonna move on here. Oh wait, do I have the key already? I do not. Okay, great. We're gonna move on. We're just gonna let our soul jars of fortune do what they do. They're probably gonna be pretty useless, but that's okay.
That's fine.
They're going to be useless no matter what, and I need to research where I need to go to get all of the shit first, and I don't want to take that time on stream because we want to beat some bosses.
Also, learnings for nerds.
Ooh, you hear that, noids?
Cram it into your library card. Nietzsche? What?
Nietzsche?
Yeah, he was a nerd, right?
Nietzsche was a huge
Nietzsche.
Nerd.
He was a nerd.
Huge nerd.
Yeah, he was a nerd. He was like, man, look how much time I have in Dwarf Fortress. I'm like, get in the cupboard, Nietzsche. No one wants to talk about DayZ.
But it's a simulation. It's a full world simulation. You can do whatever you want. He was also very old. Hey,
He's very old, yeah.
You can do whatever you want. I kind of sound like a car starting.
Classic Nietzsche.
Classic Nietzsche.
Lampy with another 200 biddies. Lampy.
Biddies.
Just,
you got biddies to
biddies,
spare.
Biddies for days. The demand for chicken mac was so big that they ran out of chicken, but got so many inquiries that they had to run a national ad campaign to say they couldn't sell it anymore and brought it back about a month later when their supplies were back. I like the fact that Lampy is as interested in these weird one-offs as I am.
I'm going to be real with you. You all are selling me on the chicken.
Yeah.
I am here for the chicken. Now,
yeah,
I wasn't before, but now I'm thinking to myself, yeah, I'd kind of like a chicken Big Mac. Okay, bye.
rollback says Nietzsche was never old.
What
is he, Benjamin Button? Did he start old and then become young?
No, because he was never old. He was a never nude.
He was a never nude.
He was a never nude. Famously, the first never nude. Nietzsche.
He was never, like, when did he, how old was he when he died? Oh, man, I didn't spell right that right at all. Oh, my God. I just spelled the word niche.
Did you spell niche?
Yeah. Niche. I was 55. That's old in terms of the Weimar Republic. 55 was like a modern day, like 115.
Absolutely. If you adjust that for inflation, that's pretty old.
It's so old.
Sold.
It's old.
Sold. All right.
Old.
Where are we going here? Where are we going? We gotta go to the fucking thing. Oh, here. We'll go here. We'll go here.
Yeah, guys, the chicken Big Mac's coming to the U.S.
I am very, like it or not, very excited.
It's gonna be fucking here.
Cause yeah, you know what? In general, I am a fan of the Big Mac. I like the Big Mac as a
You think
sandwich.
It's ratio? You like its ratio?
I do. I mean, maybe like I could go for a little more meat, but in general, like I'm down with Big Mac. I'm a Mac boy. I'm down with your Macs, both bigs and littles. Get out of here.
Mm-hmm. Little Mac's great.
Little Macs are great. I like you. Little Mac is my favorite Smash Brothers. And
that's terrible. He can't be your favorite Smash Brothers.
He's legitimately my favorite Smash Brothers.
He's just a man who with sock and boppers.
Yeah, he's got the sock and boppers. He's got the counter punch, which is so great, and no one expects it.
That is true.
And he's got his super punch. He's great. I love him. I love him.
Yeah, but he was in zero Persona games, and Joker was in one Persona game.
Oh, you're right.
Yeah. It sucks, too, because the rest of the cast of Smash Brothers was also in zero Persona games, so that's tough. Storm Templar says, don't you all have real burgers in Wisconsin, like Culver's? I think Culver's is great. Yeah,
Culver's is fantastic.
Butter burgers, little smashies?
Mmm.
There's a place called Cops Frozen Custard in Milwaukee.
Oh, my God.
Good burgers.
You want to have yourself an experience. You go to Cops, yeah. You get burger, fry, and like a little malty, like a custard.
Ooh. Box. Ooh.
Wait, what is that? There's a Red Summons over here? I've never seen
Who
that
is it?
Before. Hold on. I don't know what that is. I've never seen that.
Have you ever, have a burger at Sobelman's?
Sobelman's?
I think it's by the ballpark.
Yeah, it's by the ballpark. And you know what? Meh. That's what I said. Wait,
that's the place that's renowned for their like weird, they're like Bloody Marys that come like with like fucking sliders and like a whole shrimp boat. It's too much. Don't put a shrimp boat on my stuff.
Wait, I've never done this. Assist Yura, Hunter of Bloody Fingers. Yeah, let's do this. I've never done this.
A rare occasion where Jack is experiencing something new in Elden Ring.
I've never ever done this. This is my first time seeing this, so we got to take advantage. I'm coming. Wait for me.
Simple Simon. Oh, this is nice. Simple Simon in YouTube asked me to ask Lampy over in Twitch.
Oh my God.
How much of the chicken Big Mac is chicken and how much is just breading? Lampy, give us a breakdown ratio. How much is bread? I feel like McDonald's chicken is mostly chicken. I mean, it's quit chicken with a chicken.
So what does that do? What did I do? FYI, Jack has 389 hours into Elden Ring. I do, and yeah. You know what? Like, I've never done anything. What? So now what do I get? What happens? I've never done anything with Yura before. You know, like, when you get up on the snowfield. Oh, here he is. He's like, hey, I'm not Yuri anymore. I'm this guy. I'm Shibiri.
A little Ash of War?
Yeah. You're welcome. Here's a token of
thanks. That's very exciting.
Oh, and he gives me something. That's great. Take it. Ooh, a Smithing Stone 5. I'll take that.
He's got a very nice hat as well. I feel like he goes to the Big Hat Logan school of hat design.
Oh, yeah, yeah. I'm a big fan of comically large hats.
Yeah.
In Jean Rall.
Neil's enthusiast for the $2 donation. Thank you so much, Neil. Says, hi, Marty. Hello, Jack.
Hi.
Take this too and go get a snack.
Okay.
I'm gonna get a whole breadstick from Rocky Rococo's.
Yay, Rocky Rococo's.
That's a weird mascot. That's just the Italian man.
Yes.
Yeah, that's strange.
Just an Italian man. That's it.
Yeah, just an Italian man. That's their mascot. Just a man in a white suit, which seems like a terrible thing to be wearing when you're getting greasy pizza, but
yeah.
Who am I to judge? Lampy with 100 bits.
One bit.
This is like
this
is like Romeo and Juliet, because this is like YouTube talking to Twitch. It's like the Capulets and the Montagues. It says, Marty, please tell Simple Simon, no, it's a different type of chicken for the Chicken Big Mac. It's a tempura batter that's very thin but crispy, and a burger is about the same size as a normal Big Mac. So the chicken patty is about the size, everything's about the size of a Big Mac. A tempura.
Oh, so that's very similar to their McNugget breading.
Ooh,
so if you're telling me that they have like McNugget breading on their Chicken Big Mac, then this is now my excitement level is now through the roof.
See, this is what people should be. We should be allowed to change our opinions as we learn.
Yes, I've gotten new information. Pluto is no longer a planet, and I am excited about the Chicken Big Mac.
Yeah, they're gonna go back on that Pluto thing, right? They're gonna like say that they were just kidding.
No, Pluto's not a planet. No, they've actually found several other significantly larger planets near what they thought, or not planetoid, you know, rocks near what they thought was a planet Pluto. Like, no, Pluto is never a planet ever again.
It feels like someone had it out for Pluto. Like, right? Doesn't it feel like someone like had a personal vendetta, like Pluto like fuck this guy's wife or something? It's like, I'm going to show you. I'm going to ruin your life.
Damn you, Pluto. I'll show you who's boss. No, I think it was just like one of those like, hey, we have better telescopes now. That rock that we thought was real big, it ain't so big. Whoopsie doopsie.
Yeah, I think at a certain point, once a rock is so big, it should legally be a planet.
Yeah, or... and Pluto's not there.
Oh,
like,
shit.
Like Pluto and Ceres, like they at first they thought that Ceres was Pluto's moon, right? Was that it?
Yeah.
And now they're like, no, actually, like Ceres is much bigger, and it was never considered to be a planet at all. At all.
That'd be cool if a place had a moon that was bigger than it.
That
I don't think that's how it would work.
That's not how it would
work. It'd
be cool. We would call the moon, the moon the planet.
Oh my god, that's the forest moon of Endor? That's a Star Wars reference. SVS Guru, a 10 euro donation.
What?
Thank you so much. Says, I saw a video on how chicken McNuggets are made. I don't want to continue reading this if there's going to be slander here. Okay, there is slander, but I'm going to continue. They take the breast meat, blend it into a paste, fill it with chemical stabilizers, and press them into the forms. I bet the chicken mac is made the same way. That all sounds great.
Chicken McNuggets, to me, that's top-tier nugget right there. Chicken McNugget.
What about the Golden Nugget, the old casino in Vegas?
That's a D tier. That's a D
a
D-tier?
Tier
nugget. That's a
what
D
about tier. The Denver Nuggets basketball team?
That is that is an F tier, only because I don't know anything about them.
Enough about Denver.
Yeah.
Have you ever been to Denver?
Or Nuggets? I've been to Denver. I don't follow
Mile High City
at all.
They call it the Mile High City. It's very high in the sky. It's like Columbia in Bioshock Infinite.
Would you say it's about a mile?
That's what they say, but it doesn't feel like you're not like looking over a plateau and it's like, oh shit, there's the ground. So it's not like the place in Lord of the Rings with a moon door. Although it'd be cool if in the middle of a basketball game at a Denver Nuggets game, they opened up the moon door at center court.
Ooh.
And like if you got six fouls and fouled out, they tossed you down the moon door. But then you would die. And so that doesn't seem like a great idea.
No, this does not seem like a great idea.
For basketball, no. Some Templar says they also have a ton of weed in Denver. Yeah, Colorado's huge. It's legal.
I was going to say, they also have now a bunch of weed in Illinois, so that's not as big a deal as it once was.
No. If once something is in Schaumburg and Beloit, it stops being cool. That's the place cool goes to die.
Schaumburg. Schaumburg, who's like Schaumburg's biggest claim to fame is that they have every outlet store imaginable.
They also... when I was a kid, they had a Disney restaurant in their mall. And I went there a couple times. And let me tell you, according to my parents, it was overpriced and underwhelming.
Yeah. I am shocked. Shocked, I tell you.
Simple Simon replying to SVS Guru's story of how the chicken nuggets are made says, and I am still okay with that.
Yeah, 100%.
It's great.
100%. I know how my chicken nuggets are made. I'm still going to eat them. You know why? They're delicious.
Chat's also bringing up the fact that I'm currently at war with Illinois, which I am.
Why are you?
I got all these because I went down to Chicago. I had to go to Chicago a couple times.
Yeah.
And my fucking fast pass just is old and wasn't. Do you know about this fast pass? Do you ever have to drive in Illinois? Do you ever
in Illinois? Yeah. And I know.
Yeah.
I know the fast pass.
Yeah, and so mine is just old and apparently wasn't registering at certain tolls, but was registering at other tolls.
Okay.
It was just the exact place it would be, and I had money in it and stuff. And then I got all these bills about how I ran all these passes, and I was like, why did I run to this one, but not the one 10 miles away? I was clearly there. And then it was just a pain. It was a pain in the ass, and I was like, can you send me a new fast pass? And they said you have to go to one of the oases in Illinois. And I'm like, this sounds like hogwash. I did it though. I did it.
You did it.
In theory, yeah. I did it begrudgingly. I'm not happy. I paid them a lot of money, so I hope they fucking enjoy it. I hope Schaumburg gets to open up a new fucking mega mall just to spite me.
A new IKEA.
I would actually, but there's no IKEAs in Madison, so I would like. No, I think the closest IKEA is the one in South Milwaukee.
Yeah,
somewhere down there, down in Cudahy, somewhere tucked away.
Okay. Oh my God, he's got me in a corner. Get out of there. Hey, soul jars, quit being useless, please. There we go.
They're being very useless.
Look, they're all still alive. Look, they're just walking around. There we go. First try, Red Wolf of Radigan.
Woo woo woo.
Pop
Punk says Amaterasu is pissed. This wolf and Seif always does remind me of Amaterasu from Okami.
Oh.
I'm fine with it because I think they're great.
Mm-hmm.
Mm-hmm. Apparently everyone's saying Folding Ideas has a neat video about chicken nuggets. I like Folding Ideas.
Yes.
Have you ever seen a Folding Ideas video?
I'm a big fan of Folding Ideas. All of his stuff. Obviously, like he was the first like big
like the NFT.
Yes. What was that one called? Like parsing the line or
or line goes up.
The line goes up, yes. Oh
yeah.
And you know, wonderful storyteller, researcher. But yes, his like it basically his crusade against Jamie Oliver and chicken nuggets is, if that's the one I'm thinking of, right, where he's like just making fun of Jamie Oliver.
I think so. They're saying it's Jamie Oliver's war on nuggets.
Yes.
Is the name of the video. I haven't seen this one.
Oh, it's really fun. It's a really fun video. Cool. And it's like, it basically just shows what a dickhead Jamie Oliver is. And I think it's fun.
Yeah.
But just a good video in general.
He also has a great video on the Ralph Bakshi Lord of the Rings movies.
Yes. He's good. He's good overall. Big fan. Big fan of Folding Ideas. Great. And
Nick Nick slipped in there quick to say that's why you destroy Jarberg, which Nick, can I ban ourselves from chat? Yeah.
Yes, you can. No, Nick, I am a jar. Jarberg is my home. I was born in Jarberg and raised by jars. I need to teach my brothers how to be better fighters. What's happening.
I can't ban the escapists from escapist chat.
Oh.
I could block them, but then I think I just won't see them. I could report them.
Ooh, there you go.
That might be reporting the whole channel, which could be bad for...
Yeah, that's probably a bad thing.
All of us?
Yeah.
So I'm just not going to do that.
All right, that's fine.
Pure Pyro asks Marty, is there no editor's hour tomorrow? Pure Pyro, there is not an editor's hour tomorrow because we have our dual streams tomorrow, which I mentioned earlier at 11 a.m. We're going to be having the first episode of our new entertainment series, The Recap, with Darren, Nick, and myself talking about all the exciting pop culture stuff and House of the Dragon and She-Hulk and all that. And then following that, at 1 p.m. Central, we're going to be doing a big ol' watch-along for the Jeff Keighley Gamescom Opening Night Spectacular, hosted by Jeff Keighley, sponsored by Jeff Keighley. It's just one of the Jeff Keighley shows where they show trailers for a bunch of stuff. They said they're going to show some of the new Telltale Expanse game. We're going to see some of the new Sonic game. We're going to see some Gotham Knights, some Forspoken. Hideo Kojima always like crawls out of sewers for those things, so... we're gonna have all sorts of good stuff that. So that should be live from like 12:45 p.m. Central, and it's 2 hours. Gonna be doing a full watch along. Nick, Jamate, and myself. It'll be great. It'll be great.
It'll, you know what? It'll be great. It'll be great. It sounds like it'll be great.
It'll be great. It'll be one's crying.
No one's crying?
Yeah.
Can we get someone to cry? At least one person.
I bet. Yeah. I don't know who would be most likely to cry tomorrow on one of the streams. Probably not Darren. Probably not Nick. Probably Jameter. I'll cry.
If you, I mean, basically just if you like make fun of Christopher Nolan enough, you could probably get Darren to cry.
Did you know I just recently, well, did I learn from you that
you
he
learned
wrote the book
from
on
Christopher me?
Nolan? Okay, yeah.
That Darren literally wrote the book on Christopher Nolan.
A tenant more like shitty doesn't make sense.
I genuinely dislike Tenet. Just genuinely.
I think it's neat when they do the fight and everyone's backwards.
I think
I don't understand why they're doing it, but I think it's neat.
I think it looks stupid as hell. I think
you know what movie's cool?
What?
Prestige.
You know what? I've never actually seen The Prestige.
Oh man. As a fan of up close hand magic, you're gonna love it.
How did you
know? Are you a fan of up close hand magic?
I am.
Yeah, I imagine, because you're into, like, stopwatches and shit, so... I feel like those are pretty...
You're into stopwatches and shit. Yeah. I do... Listen, a mechanical stopwatch is something very, very special.
I agree. It's like a time turner.
Yeah. Yeah, it's great. All right, hold on. Some people got to die.
Lampy with another 100 biddies. Thank you so much, Lampy. Said, how annoyed will you be if the Jeff Keighley Show is sponsored by the Pizzazz this year? I would be hurt. If anyone gets a sponsorship from the Pizzazz Pizza Cooker before I do, I would be hurt. I've also never reached out to them, so I don't know what I expect.
The Pizzazz Pizza Cooker.
Yeah. Going to a Target near you. Oh, also Beastmarsh with a $2 donation said, Nick's war with Jarberg continues unabated. Nick needs to get baited. That's the problem. He keeps going unabated. Boy needs to get baited.
That boy needs to be baited. Know what I'm saying?
That boy, that dog don't hunt.
Jerry was a race car driver. Absolutely.
Jerry was a race car driver.
Dog will hunt.
Who's that, Primus? Was that Primus?
Fuck yeah, it's Primus.
They also did the South Park theme song. Did you know that?
I did know that, yes.
A little fun facts here.
What was I? Someone just had a funny tweet the other day about, like, the Beatles... The Beatles can never be the best band ever because they weren't on any Tony Hawk soundtrack.
Oh, dude, it's true.
Think about it.
That's such a bummer for
them.
Think
about it.
They should have made Tony Hawk's Beatles. Beatles Tony Hawk instead of Beatles Rock Band. I don't know what that is. Just like skateboarding around Liverpool.
Right. And just like listening to Beatles music, which, by the way, I bet a ton of people would love that.
What do you think would be the best game to get a Beatles version?
Beatles Prime, which is a remake of Metroid Prime where you play as the Beatles. instead of taking out the Dragon Man, Ridley, you're taking out Yoko Ono.
Oh, that's okay. Who is the Mother Brain if not Yoko Ono?
The Mother Brain is secretly John Lennon.
Who,
by the way, if we're being honest, is the real reason that the Beatles broke up. And that's okay, because, you know, nothing can last forever. But, yes, the Mother Brain, as it turns out, secretly John Lennon.
Beautiful.
Yes. All right. Here we are. Renala. Let's see if we can do this first try. I don't think we can do this first try. We did Radagon first try, the Red Wolf of Radagon first try, which is very nice. But I don't think, because I think I got to learn some patterns. But I think we can get real close.
Heck yeah.
We're gonna watch the cutscene just so we can see my dumb face looking down, which is the funniest thing in the game.
Lampy with another 200 bits. Thank you so much, Lampy. You've been wonderful this chat. Says, I hope you'll be talking in depth about Glorious on tomorrow's show, Marty. Have I told you about the movie Glorious? Was this on this show or was this another show?
You have not told me about the movie Glorious.
Okay. It's a new horror movie.
Okay.
On Shudder. You're familiar with Shudder, the spooky network?
I do like a Shudder, I'll be honest with you.
Low budget, probably filmed during COVID because it's pretty much a oneer.
Okay.
And it stars a Ryan Katwan, who played Sookie's brother in True Blood. Did you ever watch True Blood?
No.
Okay, well, Sookie Stackhouse had a brother named Jason Stackhouse,
yeah.
who's kind of like a himbo. He was kind of like a doofus hard body.
Yeah.
So in this movie, he plays a dude. He's got a tumultuous past. He doesn't know what's going on. He drives to a rest stop. He's all drunk. He starts a bonfire and stuff. He wakes up inside the lavatory at the rest stop.
Okay.
And there's a voice coming from the stall. And the voice is voiced by J.K. Simmons.
All right.
The stall has a glory hole. And he
this is J.K.
tries
Simmons
to get out
glory
of...
glory hole horror movie.
Yeah, he tries to get out of the bathroom. He can't. He tries to climb through the vents. He ends up back in. And it turns out that the J.K. Simmons voice inside the glory hole is...
an eldritch horror.
Pretorts? What's the... What word am I looking for? It claims to be an old eldritch god.
Yeah.
And says that he needs a sacrifice from this man that somehow involves the glory hole in order to save the world. And this is what the next 75 minutes are about. So let me tell you.
I'm so into this.
Wonderful.
Yeah.
Just wonderful.
Yeah. So into this. I am ready for this movie.
Yeah. All right. Yeah, so, and again, like it's like 80 minutes. It's just in and out of your life. It's wonderful. It's just, whew. Let me tell you, best probably favorite glory hole movie ever. Probably. Yeah.
Wow, that's high praise.
You know what? So this movie doesn't have glory holes, but I think about it a lot. Did you ever see the movie Green Room?
The horror movie about the
punk band who plays a show at what turns out to be a Nazi venue.
Yes.
In like the Pacific Northwest, and they have to lock themselves in the green room. I have nightmares about that movie.
It's been a hot minute, but mm-hmm. I have seen it a hot minute ago.
Yeah. I don't want to go to any Nazi bars and get locked in the green room.
Yeah, agreed.
No.
Fuck. Staff.
I like that the jars are kind of just like nipping at her ankles.
Yeah, you know, they're doing... Oh, fuck. They're doing an okay job of drawing aggro. Of course, the two of them are dead already. One's still there, and it's good if they... Oh, fuck, I died. Okay. All right. No, we're doing okay. This is okay. We learned some valuable lessons.
Yeah, what are your takeaways?
Phase one is stupid easy. Easy because of our bleed proc. What do I have in my inventory that can help? Do I have anything... I don't think I have anything that can help. I probably have enough runes to raise up a level... Actually, why don't I do that? Why don't I pop some of these guys?
There you go.
And maybe raise up a level, just because I would love some, like, just a wee bit more health. Maybe two levels I can even get.
A little smidge?
Just a little smidge. If I can get a little bit more health, I think I can really have the makings here. Because with no armor, I am taking hits.
Yeah, I wonder if you just have to get... even Storm Templar says if you just have to be crazy aggressive, just, like, not ease up.
Yeah, and that's probably what it is. Here we go. That'll write. I have to not ease up, and I might need... What I bought is... Oh, I do have a spell-proof dried liver. So I can eat anything, because, of course, jars use the things they eat to make themselves stronger. So, actually, I'm probably going to equip... Let's equip that spell dried liver, and I'll spend some time researching where all these cookbooks are and like getting all the items to craft these items, or you know, like I'll do some farming time. Because if I had some of these items that would help my damage negation, then we can really do something. But yeah, so that might
Heck
help.
Yeah.
Okay, great. Yeah, I think we got a good plan here. Summon the jars in phase two. I gotta try to drink my potion faster, so that won't take up time. If you drink your potion right after she dies in phase one, it carries over to phase two, and then you don't,
oh nice.
Then you don't have to spend that time drinking it, so I can start attacking more. Because if I can get more bleed procs, theoretically we can really we can do some good damage.
Heck yeah.
Yeah, yeah. So that's what we're working on here.
Queen of the One Ring says, what did you think about the Ronnie ending of the game? I like it. It was my favorite ending of the game, I think.
Mm-hmm.
The most hopeful.
Yeah. We're all star stuff. Guess what? We're all upgrading our consciousness. We're starting the universe over.
Yeah.
Yeah, which is beautiful.
I love it.
Absolutely beautiful. think I got a gold. Oh, I do have a gold pickle foot too. We'll get that ready too. Okay, great. We're gonna crag blade right away so we can start punching children as fast as possible, because that's really what's important here. Oop. I do like it when you just see the child fall from the ceiling.
little goo guys tripping. Right.
Beautiful. It's all beautiful. All right, child. You are broken. Oh, there. You are broken, child. But it's okay, aren't we all? All right, so now get to Ronnie herself. Oh, crap. Out of it. Oh, ooh, damn it. He made a wee bit error. That's okay.
Wee bit error.
Just a wee bit of error. All right. You're done. There's the one. All right. And you're done. And then I think it just takes two in this one to get her to come down. Yeah? Is that right? Maybe? Maybe not? Oh, there you are. All right. Great, great.
Pure Pyro says that the first phase feels like a callback to the Fool's Idol boss from Demon Souls. I'd agree. I also really like that boss in Demon Souls. I know you're not a big Demon Souls guy, but I like the Fool's Idol.
No, I think there's a lot really well done about Demon Souls. That boss fight is very interesting. You are correct.
Yeah.
Where that's the one where you have to... Oh, no. Oh, good. That's what we wanted. That's the one where you have to kill the respawner, right?
Yeah, that you might have met earlier and thought was just like an NPC that, is just kind of hanging out there.
Yeah. Yeah, so I...
And that's what taught me to murder everyone I come across.
Murder absolutely everyone.
Yeah.
All right, here we go. Here we go. Nope. Oh, crap. Oh, fuck. She's in summoning phase now. That's okay. Nope. That's okay. Fuck. That's okay. I have my soul jars. Ha 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 We did it. It's all right.
Hell boom. Yeah.
Boom. All right. Boom. Oh, I forgot
that. That was good. All you needed was. Oh, you didn't do the pickle foot.
Yeah, that's all right. Didn't do the pickle foot, but that's okay.
All you needed was one run to sort of get your bearings. Mm-hmm, mm-hmm. Then this. Perfect.
Yeah, that's all right. Let's see here. Jarberg. Yes, this is all for Jarberg. Oh, no, I do not want to be born anew. Get out of here. Get out of here, lady.
Are you going to find the secret jar codpiece to wear?
Wouldn't that be glorious if there was a jar codpiece?
Someone probably modded that in. Some sicko. What's been going on with the mods of this game? Do we got any cool mods?
I just saw a gun mod. I played the gun mod for Dark Souls that came out a while back.
Okay.
Which is a stupid amount of fun
is that like the Halo?
Yeah, that with the Halo gun?
Yeah, yeah.
So someone came out with a gun mod for Elden Ring where you get just guns and it's incredibly overpowered and, hilarious. I saw that one recently. I haven't seen anything else via like the usual mod sites that has been really fun. I know there was the all world co-op mod, which is all the rage.
That's just playing the game in co-op, totally.
Yeah, playing the game in co-op, but everywhere, you're not limited. Supposedly, relatively buggy, but, it does all right. Okay, so we got Renala, so now we are going to go, we're going to head right to Radahn and see if we can get Radahn done in 10 minutes.
Are we even going to be able to get to the festival in 10 minutes?
Yeah, because we remember we had to come all the way over here first to get our to get all of our weapons.
Oh, yeah, that's right.
And because we because we went up to Altus Plateau, the festival has started. You know what? Well, hold on. We'll go get the Site of Grace first. But excellent. I believe we can get another pouch now. I believe Renala gives us another pouch if we go back to the Finger Maiden.
Oh, nice.
So let's
Beastmarsh also with another $2 dono. Thank you so much. Beastmarsh says, good job, Jar Jar Blinks. Oh, yeah. He brought Blinks. Jar Jar Blinks.
If Jar Jar Blinks, it means you're in danger.
Those two big old eyes.
Yeah. Mm-hmm. Oh, yeah. No, this run is going to be... Okay, yeah. Mm-hmm. The fingers expect good things. Okay, great. Thank you. Yeah, this run is going to be a lot more fun and significantly easier because we can actually hit things without too much repercussions.
Yeah, so there you go.
So that should be good. Oh, we don't have a ton of great... We could try guard counters. I gotta do a little more research into the best... I guess here, raise defense when HP is low. Yeah, we'll do that one. Into the best talismans. Now that we have a talisman slot, we could go get that golden scarab talisman, which gives us more runes. Though we probably don't need much. We don't need much.
Oh, that was the one that's in the pain in the ass poison, the little poison dungeon.
The poison, right? The poison peeps. Yeah, yeah. Okay, here we are. Hello, everybody. You want me to say hello, everybody? Hello, everybody.
It's like a weird take on Yahtzee's toffee voice. Hello, everybody. It's pot time.
Hello. No, that's National Lampoon's Christmas Vacation.
Starring your favorite, Chevy
my
Chase.
Favorite Chevy Chase. When Aunt Bethany comes over, say hi to everyone, Aunt Bethany.
Oh, yeah.
Hello, everybody. Yeah. Is your house bigger than the last time I saw it? I enjoy National Lampoon's Christmas Vacation.
Hell yeah.
Okay.
Pacific Blue said, how much dono required to play this game with Halo guns? We have a 2-hour stream of Jack and Nick playing Dark Souls with Halo guns.
That's right.
That's free 99.
That's super fun. This one doesn't have Halo guns mods. The mod, as I saw it last, has a machine gun and a shotgun. And it just looks stupid. Like, the shotgun can, like, two-shot Renala. It's just very, very silly. Which I'm okay with. I'm okay with big, silly mods.
Oh, yeah.
All right.
I found that this is the Halo Today We Play. Yeah. Halo / Dark Souls Today We Play.
Okay, so the only warrior we can summon is Alexander. And of course, our jar companions. And here it is, Radahn. Full glory, Radahn. Let's see if we can do this. I don't know if we can.
Storm Templar said, wasn't the aunt in Christmas Vacation the original voice actress of Betty Boop? I don't know, but Jack's impression of the aunt did kind of sound like an old Betty Boop.
A little Betty Boopish?
Yeah. Yeah, it was Betty Boopish.
I believe it. I don't know if that's true. But I believe it. How about that? Does that count for anything?
You know what? The best part of the belief is the truth. What? That doesn't make sense. Lampy, I did miss one of your biddies. Sorry. YouTube, or Twitch needs to do a better job of giving big old notifications like YouTube does. Lampy with another 100 biddies. Thank you so much, Lampy said... Uh-oh, Jack punched her without his jar hands, runs over, time to restart. Apparently there's some controversy over whether you may have punched the previous boss.
Did I?
That's what Lampy said.
We're gonna have to look back at the tape there.
Well, it's a good thing I know a guy with a bunch of stopwatches and whistles, so you could probably do a good job of looking back at the tape.
We'll look back at the tape. I don't know about that. I feel like they fell off, but I had plenty of time.
Yeah. Pride and Balls. Yes, all the donations from this stream, whether on Twitch or on YouTube, are going towards the run of to get Jesse and Casey to play the God of War series so that Jesse can learn about Greek mythology. because it turns out video games can be good for you, even the ones where you rip women in half to solve puzzles.
Is that a real thing that happens?
In the old God of War games, yeah, Kratos is mean. Kratos is just mean. He's just covered in ash, and he's just a real jerk.
Well, he is a bad guy, yeah.
He is a bad guy, but in the new God of War, he's just the bad dad, which is fine.
Just a bad dad.
Real bad dad.
Bad dad, dad bod.
Bad dad, dad bod?
Bad dad, dad bod. Oh my god, I can't hit Radahn. My arms are too short.
It's too big. You gotta just start punching his little horse.
That's what I've been trying to do.
Get his small little, his little fucking circus pony out of here.
This is significantly hard. I think I have to not lock on to him. Because when you're locked onto his center mass, and then I'm missing him. I missed several swings there. So I have to not lock on to him.
This is going to be hard.
I think so. But Radahn is weak to bleed.
Okay.
And Macestuses do bleed damage. So theoretically... Oh my god. I can't believe I got hit by one of his goddamn arrows. No one gets hit by his arrows. Well, I did.
Gelden says, to think this run would be thwarted by enemy crotch height. 'Twas enemy crotch height killed the beast. That's the last line of King Kong. Spoilers.
'Twas not bullets that did him in. 'Twas crotches. 'Twas crotches that killed the beast.
I think we were talking about this on another show. It's weird that they say it was beauty killed the beast, because I was like, no, I think it was a combination of the bullets and then falling from the Empire State Building.
Yeah.
I think it was like, it was those two things in unison.
I believe...
And then like, far fifth place would be beauty.
I think the implication is that, is that King Kong would not have been in that situation were it not for the beauty.
Yeah, it just feels like really pony. It's like the guy who says it's the guy who brought King Kong there.
Yeah.
And I'm like, well, it feels like this guy trying to pass the buck and be like, it's the broad's fault. It's my fault.
It's 100% yeah. Old school sexism. Yes.
Yeah.
Yes. Ah, it wasn't the crowds that taunted him. It wasn't the fact that we chained him up and took him out of his natural environment, knowing that he was a vicious, violent killer. It was that girl. Am I right, fellas? All right. Get Alexander. Here's Alexander.
Lampy says that most people are weak to bleeding, Jack.
Yes.
This is true, but he's like a hemophiliac. Is that what hemophilia is? That's like when you have... No, that's when you have watery blood? What is hemophilia? That's where you bleed blood. A lot, right?
Hemophilia is where your blood has a problem clotting, I believe.
And, okay, and so it's so, yes. Thin blood.
Thin blood, and you bleed more. Yeah, so yeah, okay.
Gotcha.
So I think it counts.
Okay.
Oh god, not locking on is the worst idea. I also summoned the Finger Maiden because she doesn't do any damage. She only heals. And so she is an acceptable summon here because she won't do any damage. She will heal us all. That's my rationale.
I like the rationale.
Great.
I would just summon everyone because it would make my life easier.
And we might...
That's why you're playing it on up.
We might get to that situation. Don't get me wrong.
I like when he does... When he drifts on his horse.
Yes.
And the horse does like a Tokyo drift.
Yes. Super fun.
Oh, and TJ Carr says, I think she throws holy pots, which are kind of on point. There you go.
Well...
All pot all the time.
We'll see. Mostly she's healing us, so. Fuck. Oh, you're Crag Blading too, huh?
Got a couple of Crag Bladers.
Ooh, okay, big bleed. Fuck, fuck. Fuck. Fuck! Everything's fine.
So he's just so big. He's so large.
He's just so big. Okay, we got him to phase two.
His horse is so small, and then he goes and becomes a meteor, and it's just...
Yeah. No, and he's...
A real nuisance.
He's, I mean, like, listen, I know it's fashionable to say that Radahn is the worst, but he's just a real dickhead.
He's a real dickhead. He's a real dickhead. And he goes to space, and we don't know when he comes back.
Yeah.
It's still the Steven Tyler song from Armageddon starts playing.
I don't want to close my eyes.
Yeah.
Don't want to fall asleep. I still miss you, babe. I don't think I'm doing it this run, as I have no more healing items and one sliver of health.
Okay, but healing items are for chodes.
Yeah.
Think about that.
Okay, and I died.
Okay.
But
maybe healing items aren't for chodes. Never mind.
We'll give it exactly one more try because we're at time.
Okay.
So we're going to give it
one more.
Exactly one more try. We did get to phase two second try. So, like,
yeah.
we are on our way, which is very nice.
Yeah, we're moving in a correct direction.
Yeah, I also we'll keep it. I'm also thinking like we go back to the more iframes physic tier because he's doing enough damage where it just doesn't matter. Like, you know, he's one-shotting me anyway.
But being able to have extra time to dodge the things could be what
could
or
be
more
huge.
Grace, like a bigger grace period with our
yes.
dodges.
Could be the advantage we need.
Stone Templar says get the whole band, Jack. I mean, I think that's ultimately will be. If we don't win, and then next week is still giving us trouble.
Oh, yeah.
I think we can start gradually folding in band members.
Oh, crap. I accidentally summoned Okina this time, so we might get our wish instead of Finger Maiden, so.
Yeah, but Okina, also a big fan of the Container Store, so...
Oh, well, then it kind of works.
Yeah.
All right. Oh, you stupid Radahn. God, I dislike you.
Pure Pyro says, any games you two are looking forward to? A lot of things have been delayed. Christmas is canceled. A lot of things are delayed. There's a bunch of little games. I'm excited to jump into Soul Hackers 2. That's a Shin Megami Tensei game for all the weebs who also like cyber crimes. I'm excited for Immortality. It's a new game by Half Mermaid, the folks who made Her Story and Telling Lies. Like a weird mystery set in the world of a fictional actress and the fictional movies she made.
Ah.
Which sounds nice. I'm excited for Splatoosh 3. I like Nintendo. I like Splatooshin. I'm excited for some more Splatoosh. Mario and Rabbids. The Rabbids are just French minions, and I like having them in my life. More God of War. Bad Dad. Let's see what kind of a bad dad he's going to be in the snow. There's going to be more Pocket Monsters. They're coming back. Pocket Monsters. You thought they were gone. They're back.
I did think they were gone. They're back?
No, they're back. They're back. Scarlet and Violet. Play the bosses in any order you like. Do crimes. I don't think you can do crimes.
Did we lose Alexander?
Hamilton?
Alexander Hamilton.
Hippity, pippity, pippity. I actually really like Hamilton.
The musical?
The musical. I'm going to be honest. I assume he was a decent dude. The musical makes it seem like he was an all right guy.
You know, it's probably a little more flowery.
Yeah.
probably a little more generous.
Yeah.
On our old buddy Hamilton. I gotta find our jar friend. Fuck.
Alexander.
No, as a musical, like Hamilton's. Hamilton's great. I think Hamilton's phenomenal. A phenomenal musical experience. There he is. There he is. Come here. Where are you? Fuck. Where? Oh, fuck. I lost Radon, and he one-shotted me.
Yes.
So, damn it. All right. Well, I think we are in a really good place as far as next week is concerned. I'm probably, you know, like I'll research some better talismans. And we'll see if we can find a better combination to really buff up our punches.
Heck yeah.
But that was great. That was great. Marty, what is coming up next?
In under an hour, Casey and Jesse are going to be back with Hidden Gems playing Rollerdrome, which is like if Tony Hawk's Pro Skater made a baby with gun violence.
Yes.
Yeah, so we'll have that. And then tomorrow, as I mentioned earlier, a very exciting day for streaming. 11 a.m. Central, tune in to our inaugural episode of The Recap, where that's going to be our new weekly entertainment series where Nick, Darren, and I, with rotating cast, tomorrow will be Nick, Darren, and I, talking all about House of the Dragon episode one, She-Hulk episode one, and sort of our plans for the show. Yeah, and all that, just a bunch of good stuff. Check out Adventures Nigh, check out Extra Punctuation, check out The Anatomy, which just went up from Jemaine, if you're an early access member. That's we're gonna have snapshots on Sifu. The movie Glorious about the Glory Hole. Check that out. J.K. Simmons plays in Eldritch Horror.
All the stuff that you need to know. Great. Well, thanks for coming, everyone. Bye.
Bye, everyone.